turn it over to Dan Gardner, the CEO of Code and Theory, who joined at Stagwell in late 2015, early 2016, and has been along with us on this journey since the beginning. Code and Theory is our largest and probably our premier digital transformation company with over 1,000 people around the world. And then, as Mark referenced, one of our largest engineering forces globally as well. So let me turn it over to Dan.
Thank you, Jay. So I'm Dan Gardner. I'm the CEO and founder of Code and Theory. And the thing I really want to start with is we are a company of change. That's what we do. We're hired because we're change agents on behalf of our clients. And one thing that is thrown around a lot is this word digital transformation. It's become almost a buzzword in the industry. It's applied to almost anything that just sounds digital. But for us, it's at the core of that change. And the meaning of what digital transformation is both important to us and our clients and really talks about what we do as an agency. So I'm just going to quickly say the definition that is meaningful to us, which is digital transformation is a digital first strategy that is user behavior focused, technology driven, and data enabled in order to set, meet, and exceed endlessly shifting expectations for short-term impact and long-term change. Now that's a lot, but this is basically what's happening here. There's seismic shifts happening within technology and the capabilities that clients need to succeed in today's business environment. That is just forcing the changes that we see day in, day out. And more importantly, consumer expectations are endlessly shifting. One question I always get is, you know, what's the future? And the future is this, that it will be different than today. The change is a constant, and especially coming from a consumer. And as a brand, you can't tell how a consumer acts. You can only respond to it. And there's no industry unaffected. I think for years, we've been around for two decades now. For years, there were some industries that kind of stayed around it, but not anymore, especially in the last couple of years. Every industry from healthcare to finance to education to government and everything in between, no industry is unaffected by digital transformation at this point. And if I'm going to go down one level deeper, you actually see in a very tangible way from brick and mortar to e-commerce or distributed retail to D2C or ATMs to virtual banking or bundled content even to over-the-top subscriptions, call centers to digital services, or even recently in the last year or two to office workers to remote and gig workers. This list can go on and on and on, and the backbone to everything is digital transformation. That is what powers all this change within business. So as Brad just discussed, as Mark talks about, integration and putting these things together is imperative. And our belief at Code and Theory is a brand is the sum of all those interactions. So moving from those isolated interactions that you see organizations are typically organized as to synchronized systems. It's doing away with the one-off projects or the one-off moments in time. It's about how can you thread everything together. More specifically, we believe in this core principle that digital should be the strategy, not a tactic. And oftentimes when we see digital transformation used, it's used as a tactic. It's said, oh, let's just apply this to a reprioritization of a media channel, and that is too simple. Or going e-commerce, and that's a gross oversimplification of what digital transformation is. It is the strategy. It is the changing of what the products and services a business has to offer and how that's meaningful for consumers. It is connecting end-to-end journeys, first touch to forever touch within media channels. It is putting a technology infrastructure backbone to help organizations scale and use data at the center to be more actionable and quick. And lastly, if you do all those three things, it's naturally changing roles, talent, and governance within organizations. All of those things together are what digital transformation is needed. So when I talk about Code and Theory, it's all through those lenses of what digital transformation is. We describe ourselves as a digital first creative agency. And the reason why we say creative is creativity to us isn't just topical fun stuff. It's actually a discipline of solving problems. And the problems we are facing are transforming these businesses. And we have three very specific things that is different about us. First, born digital. We've been doing this for two decades. Digital first is something that's thrown around a lot. We are at the intersection of creativity and technology. Our name even says that, Code and Theory, creativity and technology. That's how we look to solve problems. All our people wake up every morning and that's how they think of it. They don't think about just a marketing challenge or a TV spot. They think about digital as a strategy to solve those problems. Second, we are in the business of building capabilities for our clients. What do I mean by that? These aren't one-off projects they come to us. It's high value, high change within the organization. When we're done with our projects, the business itself has a capability that they didn't have before. They're able to do something that they weren't able to do before. It's not just messaging, it's not just marketing, it's not just cultural moments of time. This is capability building. And lastly, as I discussed, we approach digital truly as strategy, not just as a tactic, and we walk that walk. We're now over 1,000 people across a network of core code and theory with some assets around us, Rhythm being a CRM and digital production company, MediaCurrent being one of the leading, Drupal, which is an enterprise CMS platform, TrueLogic, which was an acquisition we did last year, which is our nearshore nearshore technology, Code and Theory Health, which is a specified healthcare practice for digital transformation within the health space, and Kettle, which is e-commerce and digital content production. So together across multiple geographies, this is the network that we now scale across of. We've been highly recognized across our peers, humbly and fortunately. We've been agency A-list. We've been DigiDay's Creative Agency of the Year. We're one of the most recognized companies from Webby's over the last 2 decades. We've been identified as one of the most innovative companies in Fast Company, and the list can go on and on. And our growth has really shown, especially in this last year. We're up over 50%, I should also say, for legal. This is our 2021 forecast numbers, but we should be up over 50%, both top line and EBITDA growth. High margins talks to the high value of work that we do. We've been able to increase over 40% our headcount, even in a talent-restricted market. And we have recently had some incredible wins from Henry Schein to Goldman Sachs and TikTok, Con Ed, and Kaplan, which is education. We've actually been identified on R3 Worldwide, which is a trade publication that rates new business wins. The last 4 months this year, consecutively, we've been ranked number one in new business wins. And here's how we deliver our services. So data analytics, research, and testing, which we cleverly call DART, which is at the center of everything we do. You cannot be a digital first company without having data, deep-rooted insights, technology, data scientists to inform everything around that, business and organizational consulting. As I mentioned, the cascading effect on what happens within a business when going through this digital transformation is imperative to get right, the roles, the talent, the governance. Transformational technology, over half of our 1,000 people are actually technologists. So as the name Code and Theory suggests, unlike other creative agencies, we double down in technology and make sure it's a real strong force in the services we deliver. Integrated marketing, this really is about the communication downstream, first touch, way we communicate, you know, right message, right time, right device. And products, platforms, and services, which talks about the infrastructure that we put in place that are the owned platforms to create a deeper and meaningful, more engagement. Our clients are diverse across all industries, from CPG to financial services to government to consumer brands to sports. I'm going to go into a couple of these in a second. One logo I'll highlight on here is the Washington Football Team. We were behind the rebranding and the renaming of the Washington Football Team. And the reason I call that out, because why would a rebrand go to a digital first agency to do that? Because the reason is very simple. As a first sports franchise to do an equitable and inclusive team brand, it was important to have deep-rooted insights and do a digital, both research approach to understanding how, and this resonates with different consumers, but when it manifests itself into digital expressions, most people, even though it's on the field, engage with their brands and sports brands in a digital-first way. Here are a couple examples. Amazon is a recent win this year. We were awarded Amazon Ads AOR. Amazon Ads, for those who don't know, is actually one of the leading advertising platforms in the world. We did their first hero campaign, as well as year to date over 20,000 assets, experiential, out of home, and everything in between. Con Ed, we have a similar agency of record relationship where we're helping them on their journey to be a sustainable energy company. And Adidas is a multi-year relationship where we're not only digital agency of record for their originals, which is their lifestyle and fashion label, but we work on their performance. And more importantly, not just the contextual, cultural relevant stuff, but we also help with their B2B infrastructure stuff. For example, we built their B2B sell-in platforms to local retailers. Media and publishing, this is an area that we are pretty dominant on. I think we have a stat of over 150 media newsrooms we've been in over the last decade. We've really pushed innovation across the media and publishing perspective. Here's a couple examples. Eurosport, where we helped work on their international sports packages. WWE, when they were going over the top. BBC, we've been working for years thinking about how they tell stories in an innovative way, how they do mobile video first as an organization, or The Scene, which is a brand we launched for Condé Nast. We've worked with Condé Nast on several titles, including Vogue and others, but it's an aggregated video platform. But we've worked across the chasm of everything from Hearst magazine to Guardian to Bustle News Group, which we've been doing recently. But one I really want to specifically zoom in on is the CNN data visualization ecosystem, because this is a great example of true transformation. We started this project about 5 years ago. When we first started this project, we displaced Microsoft, who was been working on it for 10 years prior to us. We had to, get, within 6 months, build a parity product for the midterm 2018 elections. From doing that experience, we realized how unbelievably manual and challenging it is to build this product, because it was all done in Excel sheets. So we did three things after the midterm election. One, we built a data cloud and a platform. Two, we built producer tools. So not only for the data magic wall that John King went on, but across all their channels, producers can create data stories and be differentiated as a data storytelling. And three, build out the experience that culminated in the 2020 election. And for this magic wall, we were able to tell any type of story, from balance of power, to redistricting, to historical elections from not only the previous year, but forever. So basically, any way you wanted to tell a story, we were able to tell the story. And this was, when John King did this in the election, we were up for 400 plus hours without a glitch. Some of our broadcast competitors went down. It's been wildly parodied, even on SNL, that John King was the one that actually won the election, and we were pretty proud that we were able to do that. Here on the left, you can see an example of the Data Cloud product, and the right, some of the producer tools. And more recently, we've been working with them to extend it not only from the broadcast magic wall, but into consumer channels like mobile and web, and now even take it further to tell data story and use the Data Cloud for other verticals outside of politics, like sports and news. So switching gears, financial services is something we are pretty deep in. I think we have 9+ active financial service clients right now. Here's a couple of some of our previous ones, from life insurance like New York Life, where they still have traditional means of agents. So we created a platform so the agents can have more meaningful follow-up and connected relationships with their clients. American Express, where we did some card conversion work. We've helped launch the NASDAQ, not only the market site, the physical market site and the connected experience when a company like Stagwell could go public, but also driving to listings on their NASDAQ.com own platform, and Nuveen, which was an asset management. But one client I want to go a bit deeper is JP Morgan, because I think this client, we've been working for about 5 years for now, is a great example of true transformation across their entire business, from real estate to consumer banking to asset management and credit cards, everything in between. Here's an example of something we did for Chase Sapphire, which is one of their premier cards. With any credit card, even the premier ones, getting people to use the loyalty points is imperatively important, because that becomes a differentiation for them. So we created a service layer that focused on interest to drive more value for people's points. Or here's the example that for the private banking, similar to life insurance, it still has some traditional bankers that work with their clients. So not only did we drive leads for bankers, but when they had the first touch with that banker, the profiles were already set, so it wasn't starting from scratch. The banker actually understood the qualified leads to help sell them through. Here's an example of the commercial real estate platform we built, which was a thought leadership platform, which differentiated them from other commercial real estate, and even working within their innovation department for everything. For example, what we're looking here is their service bots, so they can have a more meaningful relationship. So that was actually perfect 2 seconds there. That is digital transformation, and that is Code and Theory. So thank you. Back to Jay.